Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to this product review, which is a brand new three-axis gimbal that's just been released by the company Hohem, and it's the iSteady version M6. First of all, a full disclaimer, I was sent this by Hohem to review for you, but they've not seen this video prior to release, nor have I been provided with any script of what to say, so all of the opinions expressed in this video are my own. So this is the new M6. The version they've sent me is the one called the kit, which includes the new AI tracking sensor, which is magnetically coupled to the top of the gimbal, which you'll see a little later in this video. So this is how you'll receive it. This is a box, and let's unbox it and see what you'll get for this particular model. So this is the box, as you can see, a nice illustration of the new M6 gimbal. See some of the specifications, up to a 400 gram payload. We've got the fill light, which is also a AI sensor, which is controlling the action of the gimbal with or without your smartphone, with or without the native app running from this device. So you can use this AI sensor, if you've got this kit version, with any app that's running on your phone, be it the native camera app or the dedicated Hohem Joy app, or TikTok, or any other platform. You can use the AI tracking sensor with that app without the referral to the Hohem Joy app. You can see it also supports external charging for your smartphone, so if you're worried about running out of power from your phone, you can take secondary power from this device and charge your phone at the same time. Features the new iSteady version 7 anti-shake algorithm, which improves the stability. 3-axis movement, so that's total 360 degree on the rotation and 335 degrees on both the roll and the tilt axis. Got a multifunction controller wheel, which here on the side of the gimbal, and that's used for controlling things like focus and the control of the light intensity. We'll see that when we look at the app in more detail. In the box you'll find you get the steady, the fill light, a small tripod, the storage bag, a type A to type C charging cable, and a type C to type C charging cable. So it depends which charger you've got, whether you can charge it from type A or type C, and you'll also get the user manual. So let's unbox it and see exactly what you're going to get. Now out of the box you'll find that you've got two axes which are locked. One is going to be the pan axis and the other is going to be the roll axis, so we need to unlock those. To unlock the pan axis, there's a little lever here on the back of the unit. You slide that down and that unlocks the roll axis, and then with this gimbal here, the motor controller, you just need to lift that up and that releases the lock from the device. So now all three axes are free, ready for you to install your smartphone. So let me install the little tripod base to make it a little bit more stable while we're operating on it. That just screws into one of the 1/4-20 threaded mounts in the bottom of the gimbal handle. So you can see that there, so let's just tighten that down. We've got a nice sturdy support for our tripod. You may find it easier to lock, say, the pan axis in that position while you're mounting your smartphone. It will take a payload of up to 400 grams, so in this case I'm going to be mounting the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra, and the other phone I've been using is the iPhone 14 Pro, so it will take both of those phones without any issue whatsoever. So to mount the phone, the particular model here is the one with the AI sensor, and you can see that at the top it's magnetically coupled, so it just clips onto the top, so it can either be used when you're using the forward facing camera, or for active tracking you can turn that round and use it with the rear facing camera. We're going to use it in the forward facing camera first of all, so I'm just going to plug that on the top there magnetically. So to mount the phone, we just need to open up the usual spring-loaded gate with rubber feet in there, and it will take phones with their case on. So in this case it's the Galaxy. I have no case on here, but I have on the 14, and that does go neatly on. So you normally fit it with the charging port towards the tilt motor. So let's just clip that in place. Slide that up. And to balance it on the top of the arm here, you can see there is a locking lever, which is here, and on the arm itself, if I can just move this out of the way for you, you can see there's a scale there which acts as a reference. So if you once you've set it, you can quickly come back to the setting for that particular phone. So first of all, we need to balance it in the left right direction. So if it's out of balance, and let me purposely put this out of balance, see it's tipping down towards the motor, we just need to slide that along to the left hand side until we get the balance right, round about there, and then just lock the lever down, and that locks it in place. To balance the tilt axis, we can then just make sure that it's moving up or down in the gimbal to make sure that it doesn't tilt excessively. So that's basically how you would just set up the your phone within the gimbal. Very easy operation. To turn on the gimbal, there is a power on off switch on the left hand side. Just depress that and hold it for about 3 seconds, and you'll notice on the 0.91 OLED screen, if I just switch over to that, as I power it up, you'll get the Hohem logo come up, and then the phone will go into its balanced state. So let me just press and hold that button for 3 seconds. You get a beep, and now the phone is balanced and can be controlled by your action. If you forget to unlock one of the axes like I've done, if I unlock it, it will now completely operate the way that it should do. Looking around the gimbal for the controls, we've got our joystick, which allows you to change the tilt and the pan, so you've got control of left and right axes and up and down axes. You've got the mode operation button here, which is marked M. You can see that is marked with an M there, and by pressing that we can cycle through the operation. So that's the all lock mode, the point of view or person view, POV, pan follow, and pan tilt follow. So the three modes. So you got POV, pan follow, and pan tilt follow, the three modes there for the operation of the mode button. Got a rotary switch here which will operate with the conjunction of the app for the zoom control from tele to wide, shutter release or start and stop record video from the button here. On the side of the unit, we've got our multifunction dial, which is allowing us to change the color temperature and brightness of the light, the fill light on the top, if you're buying the kit version. And it also controls the roll and zoom of the device as well. On the side are two buttons marked A and B, and they're for use for the panorama video mode. We can actually set the start and end positions using these two buttons. On the other side of the device is our trigger, again use the control functions of the gimbal, such as lock and returning it to its center position, but more of that when we show how to operate the gimbal. Various quarter 20 threaded mounts, so you can actually mount external lights or other peripheries to this device. The power on off button and our input charging port, so it's USB-C type A or potential divider PD type C to C. On the arm of the gimbal, you can just notice there is the output port for charging or powering your smartphone from the device. But you must notice that you can only do that in the portrait mode, as the charging port for your phone will be against the motor block here, so you can't use that in the landscape mode. But if you're using this in the vertical mode, you can power your camera for extended periods of time using that internal 2600 milliamp hour battery. Sometimes when you're using these gimbals, especially in the super wide mode, you find that in certain positions parts of the gimbal frame will appear in your shot. You can probably just see here, if I tilt this gimbal up, you can see here we're now showing the gimbal motor, which is here. You can see actually it's in shot. A neat feature about this gimbal is if you press the trigger button four times, it changes the positioning of the arms so that the motors become behind the camera. So let's just change that to the new mode. Four presses of the trigger, and you can see the device now reorientates itself so that the motors are now at the back of the screen. So now you can tilt this in any direction and you find that they're not appearing in the shot. So that's a great feature with this gimbal. So four clicks of the button and you can change the operation. With the smartphone powered up, we can actually access the Hohem Joy app, and you can see on screen we've got the symbol, which is like a iris or shutter with the Bluetooth symbol on, which means that the device is now paired to the unit, and it's a straightforward pairing operation. Just click that device. So I'm now running with the Hohem Joy app, and we're running with the back camera in the ultra wide mode. To change any of the settings, on the left hand side of the screen you can see some controls. Settings is at the bottom, the gear symbol, so you can change the working mode from pan follow to pan tilt follow, and then save that. You can see the other things, the follow speed of the motors, the motor response. When we talk about time lapse, the A to B duration, you can set the time there from 1 minute up to 1 hour. Joystick control can be reversed if you prefer the joystick to work the other way around. You've got the operation there of reversing the joystick. Up and down, you can actually change it as well. You've got calibration and restore factory settings. So photo size, you can change that to 16:9, 3:2, 4:3 or 1:1. So we'll set that for 16:9 because we're going to be shooting for video. If you wanted to mirror the selfie, you can switch that on so the selfie would be mirrored when you're recording. Got the timer and a grid. If you want to show a grid on with the cross symbol, you can put that there. Centered auto shoot, so it keeps the head and shoulders within the center of the frame. Gesture control will follow and shoot. Zoom speed. Professional mode gives you operation there. You can set the white balance and the shutter speed, etc. if you're in the professional mode. And the lens selection, back camera, so we're just operating on the normal x1 back camera at the moment. Just tapping the screen will take us back into the operation, and you can see we've got control of the zoom and the focus. So by using the on-screen slider, we can change the zoom and we can actually change the focus as well from the touchscreen. Or we can touch on the screen and set the point of focus. So you can actually control the amount of brightness, so it's really exposure compensation, by tapping on the screen where you want the point of focus to be, and you can use that slider there to set the exposure compensation for the brightness. And if you touch and hold that square, it will lock focus and exposure for you. So as the camera is moving around, it won't change the exposure. Sometimes you get that with the apps that don't allow you to do exposure lock, and you get varying scene brightnesses, which can be quite disturbing. So the fact with this app you can lock the exposure is a good addition. You've got control there of the frame rate and recording, so from 720 through 1080 up to 4K. You can do 24 frames per second with this app, so that's a great feature, and 30 seconds, which would be your normal social media like YouTube format. So here we're shooting in 1080p, 30 frames per second. You've also got the option there of changing to the front-facing camera, and again you can record with 720, 1080 or 4K, depending whether your smartphone supports 4K on its forward-facing camera, and again 24 or 30 frames per second. So we'll just keep that at 1080 and 30 frames per second. Now Over on the left hand side as well, you've got this symbol with the cross through it, the circle with a cross. That is for phase tracking. So when you turn that on and select phase tracking, you can see on the screen, if I just tap into there, the control will now switch to that green outline and it will try and follow you on the device. Now that's a great feature, but if light level dims, sometimes the app can't determine the face, and that's where this new onboard AI tracking device comes into play. And that is a great addition if you wanted it to for tracking for things like dance and theatre, that sort of operation, skating, where you want to be using the back camera and you're in the scene, you want the camera to follow you. So let me just turn off the camera app face tracking. So that turned off. And now we can use gesture control to switch on the AI device. And on the top of the device is a little red LED at the moment, which is saying it's not in a tracking mode. But if I use a gesture, let's just turn this around a little bit. And we'll zoom out a little bit. Now, for the gesture control, use the OK symbol. And you can see now that the camera has started to track me and has got me roughly with my head to the top of the frame. The LED has gone green, which is an indication that we're actually in tracking mode. So if I move around, you can see that it's tracking. We've not got the green square on the screen, so it's showing the AI tracking module is now controlling. But if I wanted to change the position, I can use another gesture, which is the two fingers like this. The green LED starts to flash, which means now I can change the position. So I can use the joystick to change the framing. Let's say we wanted it there. And again, to stop that, just use the same gesture symbol, and it will keep me with that little bit of gap above my head as we start to move it around. To stop the tracking, we just use the palm symbol and it will stop the tracking. If we're using the camera gesture system, we can turn it on with the little hand. You see on the right hand side of the screen a little hand. If I just touch that, it will turn red, and it will now give the command to start recording video if we use the V-shaped logo, and that will count down and then start recording video at that point. So now see that the camera has automatically switched over to face detection, and it's using that to track me, not the AI sensor. So by using the V gesture, it brings us into face tracking. So if you're using the forward facing or rear facing, it will pick up faces and start to track. We're not using the AI sensor, we're using the onboard app to do this tracking. If you were to show the camera a flat hand, it will stop recording. So if I do that now, it will actually stop recording. To stop that gesture control, then all you have to do is hit the hand again. But now, as we've turned off gesture control, we can't use the flat palm to stop recording. We just use the finger on the screen to stop recording, or use the pause button if you want to pause the video. And again, if you touch the play button, you can continue recording with the scene. Now, the AI sensor also includes a small fill light. In the studio here, it's going to be difficult for me to demonstrate it, but I can take it into a dark room, and there is enough light from that fill light to provide for a good exposure. So let me just turn that light on, and we do that by pressing the knob here on the side of the device, which turns the light on. And you can see on the OLED display the CCT mode, so that's the color temperature mode, is switched to on. Our current intensity is 99% and our current color temperature is 5500 Kelvin. So I can control the brightness of that by using the control wheel on the side. See, that's dimming and the value is now down to sort of 10%. Let's turn that back up again. I press the button once, it will now take us into color temperature, and I can go from 2700 all the way up to 6500, so I can set the color temperature to match my ambient light. So here in the studio it's 5500. If I triple click that button, it now puts us into the RGB mode, and that you can see at the top is saying RGB on. I can control the hue, so 0 to 360, so you've got 240 for blue and 120 for green and all the other colors in between, and 0 for red. Let's just turn that to 0. So we've got our red, or 0 to 360 is our red control. And again, press the button once to take us into the brightness, and we can change the intensity using the brightness control. Three clicks will put us back into the CCT mode. And again, we can control the intensity. Turn the light off, just a single press of the button and a double press of the wheel will put us back into controlling the focus through the app. So again, you can control the zoom via the lever on the side, which is neat, and you can start and stop recording from the button, so I can start recording video from there. Can't unfortunately pause it, you've got to press the button on screen to pause and start recording again by taking that, then one more press to stop recording. So just to demonstrate that fill light, I'm here in the understairs cupboard, no light in there at the moment, it's totally dark. With the fill light on at 100%, the gimbal's about 2 feet away from my face, so you can see there's adequate exposure, keeping the camera ISO as low as it can. There's not too much noise in the system, so you can expect to get some great effects. And if I triple click the button, we can go into the color mode. So you can see I can go red, and now I can change the hue of the fill light if you wanted some sort of special effect. So changing the hue to do that. Triple click to come back to my standard 5500 color temperature. If I turn the light off with a long press, you'll notice if we go to totally black. Well, I've been waiting all day for it to stop raining so I could go out and show you the gimbal in operation, but it's been terrible weather here in the UK for the last 2 weeks. We've had snow, ice, and now continuous rain, so it's preventing me from going outside. And we'll go down to the third steps here. Like so. We'll go down to the centre. Again, I'm just using the normal walk, no ninja walk, just a smooth, steady walk. So we'll go to the centre here. We'll turn around to look at the centre of the hole. So that is the main centre of the hole. I'll just recenter the hole there. Now I'm going to try object tracking, and what I'm going to do is bring the camera down to this bollard here on the steps. I'm going to describe the area, so that will be object tracking. We'll put that in the center, and now as I move, the camera will keep that object in the center of the frame. And double click B. And now the camera will pan to that B point over that 1 minute period. You can set additional waypoints in the app, up to 5 with different programs.
So that's 45 seconds coming up for the minute, and the minute will be the end of the video, but you can change that transition time in the app. We'll be right back.